Chapter 5, only 3 remaining. This, the finale, and then the finale, because they have weird definitions of epilogues.
Not so fast! You can't run away! You're a prisoner. You have no freedom.
Oh, I don't have a chain right now, apparently. I guess that would kind of seal the deal, because without the chain, now she's kind of in trouble. Why is she walking like that? Her whole animation is only built for her to hold up her chain with her hands. Now she just looks like she's got, like, some sort of, like, nervous disorder.
You may cause some trouble, but there is still no match for Princess Gwendolyn. Lord Brigand shall personally see to your execution.
She looks like she's in pain. Like, her physical pose and the arching of her back and her hands sticking out is all to support the chain, which, of course, isn't the biggest excuse ever, but now that the chain's removed, it just looks like she actually, like, something's wrong with her.
Aren't you? I'm Miris. I came here to earn some money. Let me help you, princess. No, you can't. If they find out we're connected, you'll never make it out of here. Princess!
So even your father has abandoned you, huh? I will execute you! And pay you back for the humiliation you gave me!
Taunting a helpless prisoner, eh? Some noble warrior you are.
What did you say? Why don't I just kill you right here?
Are you really my father's daughter? I never thought of him as my father. Go! Get out!
The protagonists in this game are very rarely interested in actually ever talking to each other.
Are they really going to execute such a lovely girl? This land is so barbaric! Look, you might as well have a good last meal!
Why not? Hey, they got shrimp. That's not bad. That's most of my money, though. You grab a milk, maybe? Yeah. Ta-da! Adding those to the collection. Alright. Oh, that's actually a decent number of food items to throw in there. Probably won't be using a warmer, which I didn't use in the first place. Get rid of the stone boots. Alright, 23 out of 45 is not bad. Somehow hurts the, Wait, is that where Odin's base is? It's not, is it? I forget where their base is located. Is it the capital alleyway? That's Titania. No, Nebulopolis is Odin's place. Yeah, it really kills the image that you're going to be a prisoner to any extent when you're... In order to initiate the prisoner-related cutscenes, you have to choose your destination, which is the Forest of Elleret.
I see the witch! Over here! Catch her!
I'm surrounded. I can't escape. Come with me! You! Why are you helping me? Your execution would deeply upset my father. It frustrates me, but my father loves you. So please, don't hate him.
Please step aside, Princess.
Stand back! Let her through!
Lord Brigand has collapsed!
The Princess has gone mad!
This is most unfortunate.
My lord!
You know what happens to those who oppose me.
This girl rescued me for your sake. She rescued me, your daughter.
Stop it! Don't say that. The soldiers will think less of my father if they overhear you.
Gwendolyn, do you realize what you have done?
My heart knows why you are acting this way. That is why I am doing this.
Oh.
Hear me, everyone. I am a traitor who opposes the king's commands. Until this girl escapes, none shall pass, not even the king.
What disrespect.
Take one more step, and I shall run you through. Here's your chain. Now go. Hurry! Gwendolyn. I'm glad to see you are safe.
How is Master Croy?
He's still in bed, unconscious. He sometimes mumbles about the Armageddon.
Oh, Master. Huh?
You better be telling the truth. So Odin cast a spell on his daughter, eh?
Yes! Please, you're hurting me. What are you doing? Leave her alone, Skuldi.
Ah, princess. This does not concern you.
Miris, it's you! Yes, Princess Velvet. I was forced to leave the castle, so I was on my way back home.
What did the sorcerer want?
I do not know. When I told him that I was driven from the castle, he suddenly looked strange.
Driven from the castle? What is happening at the Demon Lord's palace?
Princess Gwendolyn, who I serve, was banished for opposing the king.
What? Where did she go?
She is to be imprisoned in the old castle in the forest.
That girl. Oh, forgive me, Miris. This is all my fault. She sacrificed herself to save me.
Princess Velvet.
No. I cannot stand here and do nothing.
Oh, Princess Velvet.
So we're trying to free Gwendolyn. What exactly are we going to accomplish during this chapter? Because we know what happens with Gwendolyn. It's the first chapter one we ever played. Interesting how many things... Like, she gets imprisoned. Like, when we're playing as Velvet, the last thing you see is her sticking up... I mean, when we play as Gwendolyn, the first last thing you see is her sticking up for Velvet. And then we jump forward to her waking up, being the wife of, being the wife of, goddammit, names. I'm sorry, I'm blanking on names a little bit right now. Is it Oscar? I'm trying to think of whether Oscar was with the... And now I can't think of the name of the animals again. That name blows my mind how often it completely escapes my brain. It's starting to bother me. I have so much damn terminology to keep up with all these games. But the two male characters, I don't even know what I was trying to say anymore. I'm screwed. It's all dead. It's all over now. Really only works if I start with the material, huh? Let's just burn through all of our seed population. Yeah, extra frozons. There we go. I really didn't accomplish much, but sure. Anyway, while she's imprisoned / asleep, we have multiple storylines happening. One with the Dark Knight character saving her from the volcano guy, and then we have our character here going after her again. It's like there's multiple things that seem to happen all in a row while she's unconscious. It's kind of jarring to think like that so much stuff happens because she just wakes back up, and it almost feels like nothing happened from her perspective. For all we know, she could be, well, not anymore, but she could have almost been like a black hole that just consumed so many chapters of other people's storylines as everybody tries to maintain and save her constantly while she's unconscious. Obviously, there can't be that many of those anymore because this is the last remaining character. And then after that, we'll be moving forward in time, presumably. Yeah, it was a bit of a surprise the first time that we had the reveal of, oh yeah, this all happened while she was unconscious. So having an additional character also be dealing with her extensively for an entire chapter is a bit of a surprise. Although it makes sense that it would be Velvet specifically, because Velvet has reasons to feel somewhat indebted because of what happened. It's just a bit of a surprise because when by the time you wake up as Gwendolyn, you have no indication that anything happened, really. There we go. There's no Oscar, it's Oswald. There we go. Salmon Carpaccio. Thank you.
Alright.
More for the collection. Hello. Yeah, it's funny, I've never been particularly great with names, just in general. And now I'm in this situation where I'm constantly playing so many RPGs with storylines. Honestly, it's hard enough to keep track of all the names in one game, let alone bouncing between a few and being like, and that character was, and then you have games with reoccurring names, which is exasperated by the fact that so many of these games lean on mythology and history and stuff for their naming schemes, which means that other games will use the same naming schemes based on history and mythology. Like, ah, crap.
Hey, cut it out.
I'm an innocent bystander, blah, blah, blah. We've been to him before. That might be about all I can afford. Yeah, pretty much. Well, thanks for the map. Wow, this one looks pretty big. Okay. I think it's especially easy to forget the second campaign's character, because he really doesn't show up again, does he? Wait, what was this one worth in the overworld? 19? 12? There we go. 19, 12. Yeah, we can get away with an apple. That'll work. Yeah, despite being an entire campaign's worth of stuff, he doesn't reoccur a whole lot. He is the biggest outsider of this entire game, because he's not actively a member of royalty, and he doesn't actively have some kind of legacy. Did I not plant that correctly? I didn't plant that apple correctly, did I? Whoops. My bad. There we go. That enough? But obviously we have one character that's Odin's daughter, we have one character that's indebted to every single character and changes allegiances 17 times over the course of the game. We have one character that is the Queen of the Elves.
Maury's Touring Restaurant. No building, no problem. Do you have ingredients? I can make something tasty, even with leftovers. I see you have a new recipe. Please, allow me. Now then, what do you want to order?
Then of course you have Velvet, who has a historical heritage to some great fallen kingdom and is interested in revitalizing that and has a lot of important things to do and related to that stuff, at least. I mean, she's directly interacting with the object that will probably cause Ragnarok later on. But then you have the cursed boyfriend, basically. Even though he's the Prince of Titania, functionally in the story, he's just a character who goes on adventures and tries to find the essence of his curse. And it's a very individual story as opposed to a wide sweeping one, although he probably will be more globally important later. Seems like that's the highest one I can get. Yeah. Shrimp Doria. Now that we've got shrimp, suddenly it's possible to get much higher value recipes. Oh, I didn't pick up the napple, did I? Crap.
Will that be all?
Well, it'll just be a different type of ingredient. Yay! I'll get to that in a moment. What are we looking at here? This is clearly worth more. It's a brand new recipe. Makes sense. Quickly gonna run out of all of our expensive seafood, though. 30? Yep. There we go.
Is there anything else you want to order?
This is over 4,000. Over 5,000. Also over, well, this one's over 6,000, isn't it? Yeah. Yep. I think I have trouble remembering the animals' names in this game because the damn name Koopo, I keep thinking of Koopo and I can't get it out of my head, and it's not even close. God damn it, Final Fantasy. They're not even called Koopos in that game. They're called Moogles, but they say Koopo constantly. And for some reason, that's, like, occupying the brain space that my, like, pathways try to access when I try to think of what the hell they're called in this game. Oh, man. Hey, an apple sorbet. I usually remember midway through every session, and then, but I like, start every session not being able to think of the damn word.
Will that be all?
Will that be all? Probably. Everything else is kind of crap. Alright, we're level 31 already. I think we've already gained 4 levels this episode. Oh, now it's withered instead of overripe. Let's revisit that chest. Drop off what we can. Just that, really. Alright. Where do I want to go next? There's no locks anywhere. I can kind of just wander around in whatever order I want to. It's going to have sort of awkward dead ends everywhere anyway. Let's do the big bad boss fight. Come get it. Level 29. They're catching up with me. Oh, they're on both sides of me. No, thank you. I'm gonna out-toxin these weeping bells. Wow. Those are satisfying to launch off in sequence. Oh, hello. Wow, you can really just keep going. Look at all those numbers! This is great. That's great. Fantastic. Not actually that much damage in the grand scheme of things, because they're definitely still standing. I was surprised I was able to launch that many in a row. Did I upgrade that skill recently to cost less? Maybe? Just try to think of why it's catching me by surprise with its cost. Are you guys worth Fozons? Wow, how many people did that attack just home in on? It seemed like it was just gone forever. Wow. That thing stays off camera for ages. Ow. Hey there. No, thank you. That's rough that she can just keep attack. They can keep attacking me while I'm doing it. It previously kind of felt like this attack had like a freeze frame to it, but now it seems like I'm actively being punished while it's happening in a way that I wasn't before. Ow, jeez. Wow, no joke, huh? That went bad super fast. So they summon a super large quantity of dangerous enemies all at once. That's a problem for me. Hey now, calm down. Slowly plicking away. Ow. Rude. They're durable, aren't they? The difficulty curve can be all over the place in this game, you know? Lord Brigand was so easy compared to these guys. That seems to be a quirk of Japanese RPGs in particular sometimes. This idea that the mandatory main enemies are often easier than the optional side content stuff that is largely unimportant to the story. Which is weird, because oftentimes the big bad enemies are often framed as being like the ultimate villains and dangers of the world, but then the side content's way harder than any of that. Like, that was a thing in Tales of Zestiria, like the world's practically coming to an end because of some great evil coming out in the form of Heldalf. And then, like, some random drake that you encounter in a swamp somewhere is, like, 500 times harder to fight than anything else you're going to see in the game. Hey there. Get out of here. And then, of course, there's all the Japanese RPGs that infamously have the thing where there's a whole post-game where you fight where there's always, like, a series of bosses on some island or in some hidden dungeon that are all super bosses that are harder than anything else in the entire main game. That happened in Setsuna also. You beat the main game, and then it's like, but now go fight the super bosses. It's like, but to what? Like, I'm not going to be able to, they're not going to help me prepare for anything. It just seems like a weird structural choice to make. Because you're not, like, they'll make you stronger in preparation of nothing, because then you're out of game to play. Why did I do that? It's almost like giving you a level up screen after the final boss fight. It's like, but game over. game is over forever now. Why is this happening? Whee! Death weather. We're getting there. Just gotta keep my distance a little bit because these guys are being dicks. A few fire spells sprinkle in there. We'll be a little safer if one of them goes down. But in particular, I'm just trying to avoid casting that one chain attack in the middle of large groups of enemies because I got punished for that pretty severely last time. Not a whole lot of line of sight going on here, admittedly. But just enough enemies around to constantly fuel more of that attack, so that's nice. Obviously, it's coming in handy. That fire attack seems devastating. Oh, they're almost down. Seriously, though, why do the bears make the stock chimp noise? I think I've probably said this before, but it's starting to make me paranoid that, like, Japanese people, developers don't know, like, what monkeys sound like or something. Maybe I'm crazy. Isn't that the stock chimp sound? I could be wrong, but I feel like the exact same song sound plays in fish fillets. I think the same sound plays in Deadly Premonition at the very beginning of the game, where the main character crashes a car, and then like squirrels scatter because like, oh no, don't run over the squirrels, and the squirrels make a chimp noise, and you're like, what? Why would the squirrels make that noise? And I think roughly the same sound's being played here, too. Wow, I am pummeled with enemies right now. I will say this fight doesn't feel like any other fight so far. I don't think I remember any previous boss fight where you're so completely drowned in melee enemies. Just so many bears and plants just clouding the screen. That was new. Never hurts to make another healing potion. With all of them! Wow, it would require a lot of them. It would require a lot of them just to get to rank 3. Obviously not necessarily worth it. I have 1100 health now. So these ones that only have a few aren't worth that much to me. But things aren't going to mix up that well, are they? At least 2 2s would make a 3. That's good. I just can't mix the... Oh, there's another two right here. There we go. That's something. It's just the singular level 1 that's kind of a lost cause right now. Carrot here is mine. Wow. A lot of fish. I wonder if fish is a specific drop-off of the bears, because I don't... It almost makes sense, because bears eat river fish and stuff like that. It got bright so fast. It almost makes sense on some level. And it makes sense why there was so much dropped here. If it's a farm... Maybe it's a farmable resource off of fish. I've never had that much need to go after a specific resource yet, so I haven't had to pay attention necessarily to how one would get more of a resource in this game. So I've had to pay attention to, like, when a food item dropped, I haven't really had to pay attention to who it dropped from to try to figure it out or anything. So it's just kind of always been a surprise to me. It's far from mandatory, you just go for... I'm just going for vaguely level 50 with each character anyway. Let's see, going up here would be a loop that... Oh! There's a bag expansion up here. Hi, toads! No poison, please. It's a beautiful swamp you got here. Don't mind if I destroy it. Get out of here. There we go. Things cleared up nicely. Oh, no. Stop trying to poison me. Stop it. Ooh, that's a bad time. I apologize? Ish? Ow. Aha! I wanted to chain it. But it didn't really work out. Gave it a shot. That is a fun attack to stack. It just leads to such a satisfying quantity of damage numbers on the screen. Alright, backspace expanded. And fish fillet acquired. Not too much more to go. Probably about halfway there. Give me your fruits! What do you got? There you go. Oh, another one. There's always more of you little bastards. There we go. Anything? Not exactly. Alright, we're a little short on material right now. I think I'll skip for now. Yeah. We need to drop off these carreteers. There's a rest stop nearby. I mean, we need to drop off the fish fillets. Hey! It's an onion! Onions are great! I use those in some of the more... If I can remember correctly, I feel like that's an item that historically shows up in the most... more grapeseed. I feel like onion historically shows up in the highest percentage of the, valuable recipes in this game. Like, the ones that really help me along with experience. There we go. And there you are.
Hey, cut it out!
I'm just an innocent bystander! That might be the first time we've had them say the same dialogue twice in the same dungeon. They usually have something different to say when you get to the other one. Maybe it's the same guy, and he's just really fast. Let's see. He'll drop off everything except for the miracle fruit, which I might use to heal in an emergency while simultaneously permanently increasing my health. Yeah. There's so much food in the chest. My understanding is that once you beat the main campaigns, you hit a point where everybody else all, like, comes together and shares one inventory. You have 21. So I think the chests are all going to merge together, in which case we're going to have a whole lot of some of that stuff. I've definitely collected my fair share of certain resources and not necessarily used them. That said, if one character didn't have use for it at the end of the game, they probably all won't have that much use for them at the end of the game.
Maury's Touring Restaurant. No building, no problem.
There is much green here. It shall be quite a pleasant meal today. Now then, what do you want to order?
Maury, help. Heal me. I'm melting. That's, over 4K. It's not terrible. Oh, these are obviously way better. That's bordering on 8K. Ooh. That's also around the same territory, actually. Nope. Alright. Let's do some more shrimp Doria. That's very resource intensive, although it uses the two things I just bought at the store, I think. So we're otherwise off to whatever I have in my inventory. We'll see if I can get some good fish recipes, because I've got a lot of fillets in my inventory right now. Oh, there's a little shrimp there too. I didn't use it. I used it up already. Was it shrimp or lobster? I keep forgetting. It looks like lobster, but I feel like the game calls it shrimp. Yeah, it says shrimp peppercino, peperoncino, but it looks like. That clearly looks like a lobster, right? Not a shrimp? That seems inaccurate to me. I could be wrong, perhaps. That's about 8K. Don't think anything else gets quite that high. Yeah, not quite. Alright, mulberry seafood. Got a lot of the resources for the- oh, nope, just one shrimp, though. But so much of all the fruit resources, because they're just so much easier to get. That's some expensive shrimp resources.
Will that be all?
Already up to 34. I feel like I might be on track to be the highest level character in the campaign so far. I could be wrong. I think we've been over the fact that I'm constantly second-guessing the amount of experience, or, like, the amount of levels left and how I am measuring up against the campaign so far and so on and so forth. I'm always questioning it. Because the pace that you level up in this game never quite matches up with where I think it's going to be. Which isn't to say anything good or bad, really. It's just, it never quite feels like it's on the mark. I always feel ahead or behind somehow. That's about 5K. That's also about 5K. Less than 5K, though, right? Yeah. Yes? Yeah. Let's stock up. Ooh. I can make at least 4 of you. Those fish fillets are no joke. I feel like those fillets are really setting me up to be higher level than normal right now.
Will that be all?
Let's see. So now the bonus is reducing. It's only 4,400, so this one's worth more now, right? They're basically tied. Might as well finish this one off then. Move on to the next one next, as this bonus shrinks again.
As you wish.
So I believe I started this level at level 27, and I'm about to lap that and be over. Now it's only 3,700. I'm about to lap that and get to 37 if I can.
Very well.
Although there's diminishing returns each time I make one of these, obviously. 36 though, we're getting awfully close. I think I can only make two more though. 3,800. This is still slightly ahead of the other one, and it's my last salmon, so this could be our last one.
As you...
No, not quite.
Will that be all?
There shouldn't be any other good. Yeah, no other good options. I could cook that, but it doesn't amount to anything. Just 160. Oh well. It's something. Alright. So, real big chunk of experience progress here. For example, I'm now 7 levels above that last encounter I faced. Although, I don't think that there's really a one-to-one relationship between enemy levels and main character levels in this game. Which is a thing that happens in a lot of games. This game is better about it than some of the ones I've played recently, but... I'm trying to remember what I played, but I played... Jeez, that mouth is terrifying. I forgot about this guy being a straight-up Bloodborne boss. But the, there's some game I played recently where the player had a level, and the enemies all had levels, but the scaling was completely nonsensical, where, like, you'd be, like, level 12, and your enemies would be, like, level 45, and there was just, like, no relationship between the two, and you're like, well, then why did you give us a visible level if I can't, like, measure them against each other? Oh, whoa. I thought his health bar was taking a while to go down, and it's because they were going to, do that. Shave off half of his purple bar in one go. Oh, that frog just picked the wrong fight. Jumped right into the middle of that. Alright, second one down. We're getting there. Slowly but surely. Oopsie. That's not good. Just keep decking him in the face with your extendo chain. Boop! Aha! You've been avoided. What say you now? Uh-oh. Oh, wow, that actually stunned it. That was lucky. Otherwise, I was going to be in some trouble there. that was a really fast evasion. Can't believe that worked. Uh-oh. Oh, my God. I didn't know that they could home in on him straight up. He's actually really staggerable. Is that because of my level? I wonder? Yeah, I'd be curious to see if that's my level that's causing him to be so staggerable, because he seems rather interruptible most of the time. Also, it's really amusing to me, though, that the attack homed straight up at him. You would not expect that attack to work that way. Yeah, he was about to attack me, and I just staggered him directly above me instead. Weird. There we go. Oh, he poisoned me with his tail. Should have seen that coming from the Chimera with a freaking scorpion tail. Just figured I'd grab the foes on in time to be able to do that. And I was wrong, mostly. Really an A. Honestly, that went so smoothly that I just kind of assumed it was going to get a high score. I understand the score is always in the bottom corner, I just don't look at it. It's a good idea to get a good score, I just don't care in the moment. All I care about is fighting the enemy and doing well against the enemy and so on and so forth.